Hello and welcome to the Theory of Computation lectures. We are practicing problems of NFA to DFA conversion. In this class, we will practice one more problem and convert a given NFA to its equivalent DFA. Okay, so this is the NFA that we are given and we are asked to convert this to its equivalent DFA. So let's start the conversion process. And as we know, in step 1, we will write the state transition table of the NFA. So let's write the state transition table of this NFA. This NFA has 4 states A, B, C and D, A being the initial state as well as one of the final states, B being the other final state as we can see in this diagram. Okay, on state A with input 0, the machine transitions to state B and state C. From A with input 0, it could transition to either state B or to state C. On state A with input 1, there is no transition. On state B with input 0, it could transition to either state B or to state C. On input 1, there is no transition. Now, from state C on input 0, there is no transition. But on input 1, from state C, the machine could transition to either state B or to state D. On state D with input 0, the machine can transition to either state B or to state C. But on input 1, there is no transition. So this is the state transition table of the NFA. In the next step, we are going to write the state transition table of the corresponding DFA. So starting from the state transition table of this NFA, we are going to derive the state transition table of its equivalent DFA. Okay. So we are going to start from the same initial state A as always, because the initial states of the NFA and the DFA are the same. Now, on state A with input 0, the NFA transition to either state B or to state C. So, the DFA can transition to a new state, which we will call as BC. On input 1, the NFA had no transition from state A. So, for the DFA, we will put up a trap state, which we call as phi. Remember, the trap state is a state from which the machine cannot exit. So, once we reach the trap state, we will continue to remain there. Okay, so the next step is to consider state BC. In state BC, what will be the transition for input 0? Notice that in the NFA, for state B with input 0, the transition is to state B or state C, whereas there is no transition on input 0 for state C. So on state BC for input 0, the DFA transitions to state BC. So what will be the transition on input 1? So, in the NFA, on state B, there is no transition on input 1, whereas from state C on input 1, the system can transition to state B or state D. So, for the DFA, let's introduce a new state BD, which will be the transition from state BC on input 1. Okay, next we consider state phi, and for state phi, since it is a trap state, for input 0 or input 1, it will remain in state phi. Next step is to consider the state BD. On state BD with input 0, the machine transitions to state B or state C in the case of an NFA. So it will transition to state BC for the DFA. So on input 1, there is no transition in the NFA for both state B and state D. So we will put a transition to state phi in the case of a DFA. So the next step is to convert this state transition table into the corresponding state transition diagram of the DFA. So we are going to convert the state transition table to its equivalent state transition diagram. So we are going to start from the initial state A, but notice that since A was a final state in the NFA, it will be also a final state in the corresponding DFA. On state A with input 0, the machine goes to state BC, and on state A with input 1, the machine goes to the trap state phi. Now, on state BC, if we get input 0, the machine remains in state BC. And on state BC, if we get input 1, the machine goes to state BD. On state phi, whether we receive input 0 or input 1, we will remain in the same state because it is the trap state. And in state BD, if we receive input 0, we go to state BC. And if we receive input 1, we go to the trap state phi. So, this is the state transition diagram of the DFA for this NFA. Hence, this NFA and this DFA are equivalent and same in power. Okay, so in the next class, we will practice another problem on NFA to DFA conversion. Thank you.